Hey guys, I'm here again with another extraordinary tutorial about Moho. In this video, I'm gonna talk about the classification of a document in Moho and the explanation of some commonly used terms such as points, edge, path, shape, layer and group. And then we're gonna learn how to use the transform layer tool and the set origin tool, and also how to align a shape with another or how to align a shape with the border of your workspace in Moho. Let's go! To begin, let me hit the S key and select the circle and draw it. If I hit the T key and hold down the control, as you can see, we call each one of these points. And then if I hit the D key, I can delete all of these edges. And using the delete shape tool, I can delete this stroke here. And now if I hit the U key, hold down the control and select these two points, it's gonna select this edge that is between these two points. So that's what edge means in Moho. And then if I hit the A key and check auto weld option and start to drag from one of these points. And when you have a combination of some points and edges, you can call it path. So a path can be a single point or some points and edges. And if you close a path, you can have a shape. So a shape has at least one of these two, fill or a stroke. In this case, it has fill. So if I check a stroke and uncheck fill, we also can call this one a shape. And besides, if I draw a single line like this and select the edge by hitting the U key, hold down the control and select these two points and check a stroke and click on create shape, I can call this one a shape as well because this one has a stroke too. Now let me hit the T key, hit Ctrl A to select all of the points, and then I'm gonna hit the delete key to delete all of them, and then I hit the S key, select a red color, and draw some circles with different colors maybe. So now we have three shapes in one layer. So now you know that a layer can contain some points and edges and paths and shapes. And then you can, for example, have another layer with some other shapes. And then when you have some layers, you can hold down the control, select all of them, right click on them and group them. So now you know that we can have some layers inside a group. Let me minimize this one. If I create a copy of this group by clicking on duplicate and maybe create a new layer here, hold down the shift key, click on the bottom layer, right click on them and group them. You can see that also a group can have layers and group at the same time inside of it. Here you can see the summary of what I've just taught you. So now we're gonna talk about this tool, transform layer. You should know that the shortcut of this tool is M. And as you can see, I hit the M key and now I can see its options. So first I'm gonna hit the S key, select a circle and draw it here. Then I'm gonna hit Q, select it and choose a yellow color for it. Now let's hit the M key and talk about these options. Here we have the position, which has three values, X, Y, and Z. You can change each one of these values to set the position of your shape in three dimensions. In newer versions of Moho, to change a value, you can drag on that value. But the problem is if you drag on a value, as you can see, it was 0 before, but right now it's 5. And Moho is gonna save all of these values between 0 and 5. For example, if I hit Ctrl Z, it becomes 4.75. And with more Ctrl Zs, the value becomes closer to 0. Until after hitting some Ctrl Zs, you reach 0. So that's why I think if you use drag, it's a waste of Ctrl Z. Let me reset it to set every value of the position to 0. So maybe the best way for this is to just click and type, like for example 5. If I hit enter and want to use Ctrl Z, I can just hit Ctrl Z and have my shape back at 0. Rather than clicking and type or dragging on these values, just like the transform points tool, you can see two rectangles around our shape, one small, one big. By dragging on the smaller one or outside of the bigger one, you can change the position of your shape. Let me hit Ctrl Z. And you should know the difference between transform layer tool and transform points tool. When you use this one, the values that you see here are based on the selected points. So for example, if I hold down the control and select this one only, here I can see the position of this point. If I select these two points, the values that I see here are actually the position of this point in the middle of them, which Moho shows it as a circle with a plus icon. Let's hit the M key to select the transform layer again and talk about Z-axis. If the value of it is less than 0, it means that it's far from us. And if the value is a positive value, it means that it's closer to us. Using this value doesn't mean that Moho is gonna make it bigger or smaller. Let me reset it. If you choose this tool, Orbit, and drag a little bit, you can see a camera here, which was actually us a while ago, looking at our object. Let me drag more to see our object in 3D space, and scroll up to zoom in, and hit the M key to select the transform layer tool. By increasing this value, without changing the size of the shape comes closer to us. And if you decrease this value, you can have your shape far from the camera. Let me hit the home key to reset my view. That's why when you decrease this, it looks smaller than before. Let me reset it. And one of the most important differences between these two tools is that when you hit the T key and select the transform tool, you're only working on the selected points. But let me add some other shapes. Let me hit the S key and draw some other shapes. When I hit the M key and I use transform layer and I'm changing one of these values, I'm changing the position of every shape in this layer, even the shapes that I haven't drawn them yet. So now as you can see, these four points are selected. But if I use the transform layer to move these, no matter what points are selected, it's gonna move all of the shapes inside this layer. Even if it's not a shape and a simple path without any stroke or fill, we can also move that one using this tool. Now it's time to talk about scale. Just like the transform points tool, using these values, you can change the scale of your shapes. But when you use transform points tool and change one of these values, as you can see, I type 2. And although I changed the scale of this shape in the x-axis, after you type any value in here or here, Moho is gonna reset them again and make them 1. The reason is that when you change the scale of some points, Moho considers the scale of the new points as a new scale. But when you use layer transform and change one of these and hit enter, the value that you type here remains. And also there is a reset button for scale, just like this one for the position, that you can click on it and set everything to 1. To talk about the Z-axis of the transform layer tool, first you can click on window, then go to library, open it, go to 3D folder, choose props, and drag and drop one of these objects into your project. I'm gonna click on OK and close the library window. So you should know that this axis only affects the 3D layers. If I use orbit and drag a little bit and scroll up to zoom in and hit the M key to select the transform layer tool, I can change this value to change the scale of this object in the Z-axis. We also can draw 3D objects in vector layers, but I'm gonna teach you how to do it in the next seasons. Let me hit the T key and delete this shape, and then I hit the M key. Just like the transform points tool, if you drag between these two rectangles, you can rotate your layer. Also, you can do this by dragging on this value or click and type. And then you can reset it using this button. If you create an animation, let me for example click on here on the frame 24 and change the position of your layer. You can see a path here. We don't call it a path. It's actually a motion path. I'm gonna talk about it in my next videos. But for now, you should know that if I hold down the control and drag on this path, I can add new keyframe on it. And the final movement would be something like this. And this motion path is too annoying for you, you can uncheck this option and hide it. I'm gonna check it because it's not annoying for me. And the next option is flip. So we have the same options for the transform points tool. You can see them here. If I click on one of these, hold down the control maybe, and click on somewhere, change the shape, and then select it, I can just flip it horizontally or vertically. But this one is gonna flip every shape that you have in your layer, see? And now you can see that every time I use one of these two options, Moho is gonna flip the layer based on this plus here. So I'm gonna talk about this one at the end of this video, wait for it. But you should know that you can also flip your layer by just typing a minus next to the value, like this. There is a difference between this method and that one, and the difference is, let me reset it. The difference is when you click on one of these, you're not gonna see any minus here. So to flip a layer using these two options can sometimes be better because it's gonna keep these values one. And for example, when you change your scale and you want to reset them, it's not gonna reset your flip. But if you use this method and maybe change your scale and you want to reset your scale, rather than setting everything to one, it's gonna also reset your flip. So just trust me and use these two. Let me drag from here to here to select all of these keyframes. I hit the delete key to delete all of them. Let me hit the T key, hold down the control and select this shape. Then I hit the delete key to delete it. And now I'm gonna hit the M and talk about this option, align layers. If I click on this, I can see different options, but they're not active here and their colors are gray. It's because when you want to use this option, you have to select multiple layers. Right now we only have one, so I'm gonna create another one. And now if I hold down the control and select all of them, you can see that this option is available now. Using this option, you can align your layers with each other. Like for example, let me click on here, hit the S key, choose a red color, select rectangle, and draw. Then I hold down the control and select the other layer and hit the M key. Most of you may think that this option has some bugs, but all you have to do is that you just have to learn how it works and learn about its weaknesses, and then you can use it. So when you use left, Moho is gonna go through every layer that you've selected and find the point that is more left than the others among all of the layers that we have selected. And then it moves every layer to the left to align the left side of them with this point, see? And for the right side, because these two points are more right than other points that we have in all of these layers, if we use right, it's gonna align the right side of every layer with these two points. We can say the same thing about the top, that Moho considers these two points, and bottom, that Moho considers this point. And when you use center horizontally, Moho goes through every selected layer, and for every layer, Moho finds the point that is more right than the others, and finds the point that is more left than the others, and then it considers a point in the middle of them. And now if I click on here and use center horizontally, it's gonna align all of those middle points to have the same X value, or you can use this one to have the same Y value. But these options also have some weaknesses, because if I hit the T key, move one of these points to the right, and then I hit the C key and change this curve, and then I hit the T key again, the most left point of this layer, the yellow one, should be this one. But we don't actually have a point here. That's why Moho is gonna consider one of these two points as the left side of your layer. And now if I hit the M key and use, for example, the left option, Moho is gonna align the other layer with these ones, with where the points are and not there. There is not an accurate solution for this, but you can just hit the A key, put a point here maybe, or maybe hit the S key, uncheck autofill and autostroke, and draw a hidden shape here to have some points at the left side of your layer. But it's not an accurate solution. Let me hit Ctrl Z. In this kind of cases, it's better to align your layers manually. Let me hit Ctrl Z multiple times to have our circle back. And now it's time to talk about align your layers with the border of your workspace. I sometimes see that some users say that there is no way to align your layers with these borders, but there is one way, and that is you just have to go here, click on View, and use Enable Grid, Before using it, you can see that the shortcut is Ctrl G. And if this is your first time, the first thing you should do is to set your grid setting. So I'm going to click on here to open the grid setting. And from here, you have to choose a square. I usually use 20 for grid spacing. This value shows the space between every square in your grid. I'm going to click on OK. And now I can see the grid. But before I use it, you have to make sure that your grid snapping is enabled. If you don't see any check here, it means that your snapping is enabled. And if you check it, you can disable it. So now I have to go here and make sure that my grid snapping is enabled. And now using Ctrl G, I can show or hide my grid. And using grid snapping, if I, for example, want to create a shape, the points of my shape follow the grid. And using this method, I can define the borders of my workspace to align all of my layers with. But if I scroll up to zoom in, you can see that our grid doesn't match. The reason is we've moved the layer. So let me hit the home key to reset my view. Every time you move your layer, you are also moving its grid. So this grid that we're looking at is for this layer. We can create a new layer, call it workspace. Move it to the back of every shape that we have. And if I scroll up, you can see that we don't have any problem with it anymore. I'm gonna hit the home key again to reset my view. Hit the S key to select the draw shape tool. Uncheck auto stroke and auto fill. And draw the borders of my workspace. Now I can simply hold down the shift, select all of the layers. Hit the M key to select the transform layer tool. And align every layer that I have with the borders of my workspace. And one thing about Moho is that always a layer should be selected. You can't deselect all of the layers. At least one should be selected. So to deselect some of these layers, the only thing that I can do is that I can select one of these layers by clicking on it like this. Let me delete it and delete layer 2. Then I hit the T key and delete this shape, and I hit Ctrl G to hide my grid, click in the middle of this shape to select it, and move it to somewhere around here. Then I hit the M key and reset its position. Now I'm gonna talk about this one. As you know, when we hit the T key, we can see an anchor point here. The anchor point of the Transform Points tool is always at the center of the selected points, and we use it to rotate the selected points around it. So for example, if we move it to somewhere around here and drag somewhere between these two rectangles, we can rotate our shapes around this anchor point. And if I hold down the Ctrl and click on somewhere and select those points again, Moho reset that point to its first position. But for layer, we call the anchor point of it origin. And to set your origin, you can hit the O key or use this tool and click where you want your origin to be, like this. And then every time you want to rotate your layer, Moho rotates every shape in your layer around your origin. I'm gonna hit Ctrl Z again and hit the O key to select the origin tool. And to reset your origin, you can hit reset here. So your origin is actually a point that has its own X and Y values, and you can change them or reset them. And there is no difference between these two options and these two, both are the same. And that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Would you like to see more? Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next one.